Hi, my name is Charlotte. I'm a current fifth year at the University of Southern California, majoring in chemical engineering with a minor in technology commercialization. And today I'm going to be talking to you about how to decide your college major. So I'm going to be covering combining your passion with practicality, navigating college undecided, as well as deciding if you would like to change your major. So starting off with combining your passions with practicality, I've always been a firm believer that if practicality is something that you're really looking for, there is some way for you to combine something you're really interested in with a more historically practical route. For me, I knew that I loved makeup and cosmetics, and I wasn't entirely sure which route that was going to take me. I knew I loved my YouTube channel, and I loved being able to create content related to the beauty industry all throughout high school. And so when I was trying to decide my college major, I wasn't sure exactly where that would fit in with a career. I also knew that I loved math and science, so engineering was something that I was kind of considering, but I had always thought of engineering as the more historical, like civil engineering, building bridges, or mechanical engineering, working with like machinery and cars and things like that. And I never thought that was anything that I was interested in until I discovered that there's so many other types of engineering and so many different routes that you can take with it. And my senior year of high school, I realized that there was a way for me to combine my passion of the beauty industry with chemical engineering, which is something I hadn't really considered before. So I did the research and looked into becoming essentially a cosmetic engineer, a chemical engineer who works in the cosmetics industry, doing things like formulating cosmetics, working in R&D, kind of sitting down and formulating shampoo or conditioner or skincare or the actual makeup. And it seemed like a really interesting route. And I found out later once I got to college that there were a lot of other people who were also interested in that route. And at USC, for example, there's an entire club called the Society of Cosmetic Chemists at USC. And we're a chapter at the University of Southern California of this national organization of people who are cosmetic chemists. So it was a really interesting way for me to stay engaged and interested in a major that otherwise I think I may have found a little bit more boring. And I really loved being able to apply it all 4 years and join extracurriculars that made it more interesting to me as well. But I also think it's important to kind of know that things can shift, and just because this is what I started off in college wanting to do, technically it is what I'm going to be doing after college is over. I was still experimenting and looking at other ways that I could be combining this passion in the beauty industry with engineering. And I came to learn that packaging engineering was another option where I could be working in more of the operation side of the industry and work on the packaging, not just of the like secondary packaging, but what the makeup is actually being held in. And there's so much that goes into the material, how the makeup formula interacts with that material, and how it all comes together, how the consumer looks at it, if they're willing to purchase it or not. And that was an extremely interesting experience, a way to apply my major that I hadn't thought of before. So I always like to tell people to really look outside of the box and think about other ways that you can be applying what you've been learning to industries that you could be interested in, and to keep an open mind and know that sometimes things will shift and sometimes what you were initially intending to do with your major could change over time. There's no shame in changing majors, but we'll talk about that a little bit later. But if you aren't even really sure where to start and you don't know what you love, or you don't know of a way to like combine what you love with something your parents might approve of you doing, I always say start with looking at your interests and your hobbies, which may seem very obvious. But like I said, in my case, I really loved my YouTube channel and I wanted to find a way to combine that into what I was doing in my daily life. I have friends who were very interested in sustainability and joined a lot of sustainability clubs when they were in high school and wanted to do something with that with their career. Maybe you're really interested in something along a marketing route or a fashion route or cinema. There are so many different hobbies and clubs and extracurriculars that I'm sure that you were involved in high school that can give you a bit of a clue as to what you might want to do long term. And another great way is to talk to friends and family who have already gone to college and decided what they were majoring in and asked them, what did they like about it? What did they not like about it? What do they wish that they did differently? I didn't have any engineers in my family, so I didn't have many people to talk to at first, and I had to reach out to friends and siblings of friends to kind of ask if this was something I could be interested in. And now my little brother also wants to be an engineer, and he has been using me as a resource, and all these tips I've been giving in videos I have been giving to him as well, as he is a senior applying right now. So it's important to talk to people instead of just doing research online and really get a firsthand point of view if this major you're considering is a major that you should be looking into. And I would definitely recommend talking to more than one person because everyone has slightly different experience and not everything is meant for everyone. I think it's also important to note that sometimes your major isn't exactly what you're going to end up doing, if that makes sense. I've always said that I don't want to use my major, I want to apply it, where I've spent the last 4 years learning how to build a chemical plant, which is something that I never really intend on doing, even though I'll be working in manufacturing for 3 months, but long term, I never intend on doing or using my degree for a lot of the classes that I was in. But my major taught me a lot of the skills, and it is the major that I typically would need to qualify for certain positions, and I think it helped me build a certain mindset for the field that I am looking into. So there were many times when I heavily considered changing my major because I wasn't entirely sure that's what I wanted to be doing for 4 years, only for me to realize that I knew it's what I needed for the career I wanted. And I was looking towards those 4 years, like I was looking after these 4 years of college and thinking to myself, what do I want to do at the end of the day? And I knew it was working as a cosmetic chemist, and I knew I had to have a chemistry or chemical engineering degree in order to do that. And really pushed me through the last 4 years and helped me realize that the end of the day, even though it didn't seem like it was the right path, I knew that it was, and it did get me into the career and the industry that I wanted to. So I would definitely recommend just doing research and look at job openings on LinkedIn or Glassdoor or Indeed and see what majors they're asking for positions that seem interesting to you, and then go from there. I think that's a great way to start as a good jumping off point. Because it's important to know that you don't have to decide right away. There's nothing locking you in to this one major. So might as well do research, talk to people, and just figure out where you wanna start looking. And so hopefully it makes the process a little bit easier. So next up, we're gonna talk a little bit about navigating college undecided. So this will depend a little bit on whatever college you go to in terms of how they handle this process. There are some schools where you don't even declare your major until sophomore year. And there's some schools that really want you to declare right off the bat. And if you go in undecided, they will constantly be introducing you to new majors and trying to get you to declare as soon as possible. So there are a couple of routes that you can usually go with this. And one of them is just staying undecided for a little bit and checking out different majors, take a couple classes in a bunch of different schools and kind of figure out what might interest you. Another route is just choosing a major. If you have a ballpark, let's say you know you want to be an engineer, but you don't know what kind of engineer, you can just stick to that, pick a certain type, stick to it, and then go from there if you decide that's not what you like. So basically your two options are kind of a diverse class schedule to start off and figuring out where you want to go, or pick one thing, see if you like it, and move on to the next thing. Because depending on your school, there's usually no harm in switching between different majors, but like I said, depends on your school. USC, for example, if you want to switch from business to engineering, you would have to go through a process and apply, and it usually takes like a semester or so of you getting certain grades, taking certain classes, and then they will most likely approve you for admission. So it is important to do some research if you plan on going into college undecided, if the school you're going to allows you entry into all of the schools within that college or just the specific school that you are looking into. So it's definitely something to take note of. Another important thing is if you are going in undecided is to make sure that the school you're looking at is fairly diverse in the majors that they offer. If you were going to a liberal arts school and then decide that you'd like to do engineering, you'd most likely have to end up transferring. So although you don't definitely have to decide on a specific major right off the bat, it is helpful to maybe know a ballpark of, oh, I want to be a business major, or I want to go into the arts, or I want to go into engineering, and try to focus on schools that have better programs for that type of major, or going to a school that has great programs for a lot of diverse different majors. So if you did decide to switch, it wouldn't be a huge deal. Then if you get to campus and you still aren't sure, I think the number one piece of advice I can give you is just talk to your friends, talk to your peers. I've learned about so many different majors that I never knew existed since coming to college, and even out working in industry too and doing internships, I have met people who were certain majors that I never even heard of, and I wish I had looked into that earlier and even applied to schools that had some of those majors. So I do think it's important to be looking around, talking around, going through school's catalog. And if you're interested in it, then go and take a class or two in it so that you can kind of get a sense if it's something that you would like, in addition to just your friends saying it's something that they're interested in. All right, lastly, we're going to go ahead and talk about changing your major. So changing your major can be very scary, and it can feel like a very big leap, especially if it's your first time doing it, and especially if it's later on in college and you feel like you might need more units than you can fit in, might have to stay there longer, take summer classes. There's a lot that can go into it. I personally was very close to changing my major sophomore year of college. I just wasn't getting very good grades. I was really struggling. I, like I said earlier, didn't feel like my major was leading into exactly what I wanted to do, and I struggled a lot, and it was a very hard decision. But I sat down and I talked to a lot of my friends. I talked to my friends currently in my major and my friend in the major I was considering switching into, and I will admit most people encouraged me to switch, and I was very close to doing it. But at the end of the day, I knew this was the major that I needed to lead me into the career that I was very sure that I wanted, and I personally felt like I could do everything plus some with my current major. But with the major I wanted to switch into, I could only do some things. It would limit me to more of like a business role as opposed to a technical role, and I wanted the flexibility after college of being able to switch careers into something more businessy or something more technical or something more just on the engineering management side of things. I just wanted to have options, which is why I personally decided to stay in my major. I will admit I was also afraid to make the jump, but I don't regret it in the long run. But on the flip side, I have plenty of friends who switched their major and were so, so glad that they did it. I have friends who switched their major up to 9 times, and I have friends who added on minors, who added on double majors. You don't always have to make a super drastic decision to switch your major entirely. Like I said, you can add on a minor and focus on that and find a way to kind of combine two different things that you're interested in. Like I have my business minor right now, which has been a great way of me kind of combining an engineering side of things with a business side of things without changing my major entirely. And I also didn't have to go through the process of applying to the business school at USC, because usually with minors at most schools, you can just add them on without having to go through an application process. I do think it's important, like I said, to remember that it's never too late to change. I have friends who changed going into their senior year, junior year. Sometimes you do have to add on more time, so that might be something to factor in your decision. But your advisors should be there to help you and should be there to come up with a course plan to make it happen, to help you graduate in 4 years if that's something that you really want and you really are looking for. So I would definitely recommend sitting down, talking with your advisor, talking with people maybe who you know made the same jump that you want to make, and kind of figuring out what route they took, seeing if classes you took previously can count for classes you want to take in the future and things like that. I know it can be a difficult decision and a scary decision, but my biggest piece of advice, doing research and talking it through with people so that you know as much as you can before you make that decision. So I hope you enjoyed this lesson on how to decide your major in college. And if you have any more questions, feel free to reach out to me or to sign up for one of my tutoring sessions if you would like to talk this through a little bit more one-on-one and to get some personalized advice. So I hope that was helpful, and thank you all for watching.